Hey guys, Brian here. Welcome back to the shop. Got a job here today, so let's take a look. This one shouldn't be too terribly bad. Basically, I've got this hub, which is available. And this is an obsolete hub. The shafting part is the same, and they look to be the same other than this diameter here is different, and the bolt pattern is different. So my task is to make this hub center, make this hub center the same as this hub center, and make this bolt pattern the same as this bolt pattern. Then this will work for this obsolete job. So what I need is a ring, because this is smaller diameter than this is. So I'm gonna take my piece of tubing there that's holding my chuck handle and chuck it up and turn the ring off of it, because that's the only piece I got that's gonna be close to the right diameters to make this ring out of. So I'm gonna get that set up. I'll bring you back. Face this off. See if I can hit 3200 here. Go 3150 first. Like 3200. little heat, I think that'll go. So now I want to turn the OD. Much better chip than 100. Measuring 47, missed the two. Warm enough to shrink two? Maybe. Let me see what the spec was. 89.8 to 90.6. Parts 90.1. Off. Anywhere with this little blade. Eccentricity in this thing, so I'm gonna make an arbor to mount this hub on and correct it. Eccentricity. Well, that looks a lot better as far as my OCD goes. Still didn't clean up all the way around, but at least it looks halfway straight. So I went ahead and turned a little register on the slug that I used for the friction drive. Since it fits this hub nice, there's no play, I can use that to sweep to get the bore center and won't have to worry about this keyway in here messing up my indication. So it's a quick little trick you can do to make it easier to set up. So I'm gonna fire the mill up, come over here, indicate this in, find my center, and then I'll do a bolt hole circle to put the four holes in here where they belong. So get to it. Well, I hope you enjoyed getting to see that quick little job of converting this into one of these. So, find it interesting that this one hole lined up like perfect and the others are a little off. Makes me wonder if they had them a little off when they made it. Could have been like that eccentricity that was in it. So, not sure how many operations they did to make this part. If it was done in one shot, or if it was on two different machines, two different setups. It goes on a hay rake, so it's not super critical. It's not turning real fast, and if it moves a little bit, probably not the end of the world. So, I know on the print, it didn't give any tolerance dimension for the holes. It just said they were 13 millimeter. I went half inch, because I don't have any 13 millimeter drill bits. So, I'm pretty sure half-inch bolts go through here, and my half-inch bolts will go through after I milled them out and got the holes where they belong. Mine should be correct because I did them on the mill. These others may have just followed probably some long drill bits so they would clear this hub length with the spindle. And they may have just walked off that much. Could have been not clocked exactly perfect either, but ought to do the job, and certainly better than this one. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I'll catch y'all later. Well, Inspector, does this get the wag of approval? Well, Bailey, does it look good? Must be. Look like the wag of approval.